Hi, my name is Bruce Doran. I'm one of the staff scientists that works at Science North. And February is Heart Month. And I want to explain two medical procedures I've been asked a lot of questions about. What is a stent and what is bypass surgery? And before we really talk about these, let's look at a model of a human heart. So I've got one right here. The human heart is just a big muscle. And if you open this model, you can actually see some of the cavities inside the human heart. So blood enters the upper cavities. So there's one here, they're called atrium. This is where blood enters the heart from different parts of the body. Then the blood gets pumped from there to the ventricles, where it then gets pumped to the different parts of your body, whether it be your lungs or throughout your entire body. Now, the heart muscle, just like any other muscle, requires blood constantly and especially oxygen. Now, the interesting part is that the heart muscles don't get that oxygen and blood through these cavities. They have their own arteries. We call these coronary arteries, which feed the different muscles of the heart. Now, what happens, sometimes you get a plaque buildup within these different arteries, and unfortunately what happens, if there is a blockage, the muscles that are essentially downstream don't get blood and oxygen and potentially could die. So this can lead to a heart attack, and unfortunately if it's really, really bad, could lead to cardiac arrest. So the medical procedures help to alleviate that. So a stent is essentially just a tube. They insert a very small tube, usually through a catheter, through different arteries of your body, usually some of the larger one. They insert it to open that blockage to allow the blood to flow through. But sometimes that is not enough. Either the blockage is too great, or they did put a stent and the blockage reappeared. So essentially what they do is they take an artery, let's say from, you know, an arm, another part of your body, and they attach it before and after the blockage. In other words, the blood will bypass that blockage to then feed the other parts of the muscles. So essentially these two procedures allow blood to go from point A to point B of the heart muscle to ensure that the heart muscle gets enough oxygen and blood in order to function properly. Because frankly, we've only got one heart and we want to make sure that it's working fine.